So let's get started. I just wanted to use this session to go a little bit more in with the chair and moment diagrams, which is such an important topic. And I wanted to give you a few more tools about how to do those diagrams. So I'm gonna do a couple of examples today to cover those tools. The first one is using the integrals to get the equations. We didn't do that in the previous examples, so I'm gonna do that here. I'm gonna show you how you can take advantage of the fact that the shear is the integral of the load and the moment is the integral of the shear. So let's get started. All right, let's take a look at this example here that I have on the screen. It's a simply supported beam with a triangular load. Intensity at point A equals to 20 pounds per foot, length of 6 feet. Remember, first thing you have to do in order to do a shear and moment diagram is to find the reactions. Let's do that really quickly. You guys have to be very sharp at finding reactions, no? So we have here the beam with the reaction at A, the reaction at B, the triangular load. And the triangular load cannot be considered as triangular for the calculation of the reactions. You just have to replace that by a concentrated equivalent load that in this case is gonna be the area of the triangle. Well, here you have 20 and here you have 6 feet. This is 20 pounds per foot. So the area of that triangle is equal to 1/2 of 6 times 20. So that will be 60 pounds. And then with a summation of moments about point A equals to zero positive in any direction that you want, it doesn't matter, it will give you always the same answer. So you have that minus RB times 6 plus 60 pounds times 2. We already developed the centroid of a triangle, right? Is 1/3 of the height. In this case, will be 1/3 of 6 here. 1/3 of 6. And in this distance will be 2/3 of 6. So this is equal to 0. Therefore, R is equal to 1/6 of 120 divided by 6 is 20. Okay, so we found 20 here. This is 20. You can put it here also. 12. Okay, now summation of moments about point B equals to 0. You can put positive any direction we want, it doesn't matter. You will get the exact same result no matter what. You have here that RA times 6 minus 60 pounds times 4 equals to 0. So RA equals to 60 times 4 divided by 6. That's 10 times 4 is 40. 40. So we have another, this is 4. And then you check that summation of forces in the y direction is correct. You have 40 going up, 20 going up, so 60 going up and 60 going down, then you have equilibrium in the y direction. So we have here a 40 pound load and we are ready for our shear and moment diagrams. But we are going to do it by equations. So in order to do this by equations, let me move this calculation of reactions a little bit out of the way. Then we know the fact that the shear diagram is equal to minus the integral of x dx. How to use these integrals of these equations in order to find the important, the salient values of your diagrams. Sometimes just what we discussed later before about going according to what the arrows say tells you to do and summation of areas it's not enough to find certain values important on the diagrams. Like this one here. Let's go for this. So in order to do the integral of the load, first we have to find the equation of the load. The equation of the load in this case is a straight line that is going down like this, right? It's a straight line. So the equation is mx plus b, right? Where the slope is negative slope. The slope in this case is w0 over L. So the slope is minus 20 pounds per foot over 6 feet. So it's equal to 3.33 pounds per foot per foot. And the B, the intercept with the y-axis is W sub zero, so it's 20. In that case, our equation of the load is equal to minus, I have a minus here, right? Minus 3.33 x plus 20. Minus 3.33, that's the equation of the load. Let me put this into a red square, which is okay, very important piece of information. We're gonna start out of that. So now we're going to calculate the shear diagram as the integral of minus the integral of the load dx. So this is equal then to minus the integral of minus 3.33x plus 20 times dx. So this is gonna be equal to integral of 3.33x minus 20 dx equals to 3.33 x squared over 2 minus 20x plus c sub 1. So in order to find our constant of integration, we need to use a particular condition that is known on this beam. And we know that the shear at point A, so when x equals to 0, is 40. If we get started with the diagram, remember what we do, we come here, boom, we find a 44, so we go here at 40. 40, this is 20, this is 40. And then we start going down, according to the arrows here. The arrows say, go down very quickly, and then not so quickly, and then with zero slope at the end, so horizontal at the end. This is zero slope here. So we know that the shear diagram starts at 40 up there. That's the shear value right after you start to the right of point A at the left support. So that's the value that we're going to use in order to calculate our constant. You see that the shear at x equals to 0 is equal to 40. So we replace x by 0 and we have 3.33 divided by 2 is 1.67 times 0 minus 20 times 0 plus c sub 1. Therefore, c sub 1 is equal to 40. So we got our final equation for the shear diagram. Shear diagram equals to 1.667 x squared minus 20x plus 40. So this is the equation of the shear based on integration of the load. And now let's do the moment as integration of the shear. Moment of x is equal to the integral of this year. So this is equal to integral of 1.667 x squared minus 20x plus 40 dx. So it's equal to 1.667 x cubed over 3 minus 20 x squared over 2 plus 40x plus c sub 2. Right? Now, if we know the moment at any given point, if we try to start our diagram here, since we have a pin support at support A, we know that the moment is zero at the beginning, and this is going to go something like that, but it's zero at the beginning. So with that knowledge, we can find our constant that we will say that moment at x equals zero is equal to zero. So this is equal to 1.667 is 0.555556 times zero minus 10 times zero plus 40 times zero plus c sub. So now we have the constant of integration for the moment equal to zero. So our equation of moment is equal to 0.556x cubed minus 10x squared plus 40x. And that one goes into a square also. All right, wonderful. So now let's do our diagrams. Let's go back to your diagram. We went here, 0, 0, 0, 0, then boom, we have the 40 going up. So we go up 40, 40, 40, 40, up to 40. And then we start going down according to what the arrows tell us to do. And the slope of the shear is the load. So the load is telling us to go down very quickly at the beginning. And then slowly, 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 until at the very end, the shear is zero slope because the load is zero. So at the end goes horizontal, horizontal. That's what I say here. And then at this point we find the 20 pound load. So we have to go up. Oh, but hold on 1 second. What is the value of the shear down here? Hold on 1 second. We need to find several things here. First, it's very important to find where is the location of this zero shear here? Let's call x sub zero. And the other point important is where is the value of the shear down here at the very lowest point? This value at the very lowest point is actually very easy to find because it's this value of 40 minus the area of this triangle here, which is we already know it, is 60 pounds, right? Because we found it is just the concentrated load that we use as equivalent to the triangle. So we found this to be 40 minus 60. So this is minus 20. So this is here minus 20. And then we find the 20 load. So from minus 20 plus 20, we end up here at zero. So it ends up here at V equals zero at point B. All right. Now, in order to do the moment diagram, we do need to find the X sub zero here because at this value of zero shear means that the slope of the moment diagram is horizontal. This horizontal slope, very important because whenever you have horizontal slope, you have either a maximum moment or a minimum moment. In this case, it's a maximum moment. Let's find x sub zero. X sub zero we can find based on the equation. With our equation, we can find here that we say shear x equals what equals to zero. So we replace the equation 1.667 x squared minus 20x plus 40. And we have to solve this equation in order to get the location of the zero here. If you guys help me with the solution of that equation, well, actually, I can get in here with the magic of my OneNote. And I have two solutions. For x equals 9.46 or 2.54. Okay, so those two solutions, 9.5 and 2.5 is this one that we were looking for here. This is 2.5. And 9.5 is that if you continue this equation, you will remember this is 6 here. So 9 is around 3, 6, 9, around here somewhere. So this equation probably goes something like this. And that's the other solution, which is outside of the bin. We don't care. So the, only the 2.54 is the one that we really care. So let me erase this part here that we don't care. And 2.54, our graph is not that bad. It goes up to 40 at the beginning, goes down to 0 at 2.54, and goes to minus 20 at support B, and then close to 0 with the reaction of 20. Now for the moment, then we say that the moment starts at the beginning with a very steep slope, positive slope given by this 40. At this point, has to be horizontal, and then the slope begins to increase from 0 to negative values to a maximum at the support B. So the shape should be something like this. Something like that. With 0 here, with 0 slope at that point, which is the maximum moment. And that maximum moment is a very important feature of the diagram. So we need to find it, and it's very easy to find it since we have already the equation. So we enter the x value in this equation, and we got moment at x equals to 2.54 equals to 0.556 times 254 cubed minus 10 times 254 squared plus 40 times 254. If someone can do that for me, because my OneNote is not that perfect yet. But let's see how that's to this. Anybody got one? 46.2. This is actually pound feet. 46.2. So this value here is 46.2. All right. So that will be the end. That's the two diagrams with all the important points. It's important to annotate this value here and this value here, the location of the maximum moment, which is the location of the zero shear. Those locations are very important, and those values are very important. This value is also very important in order to define your diagram complete. Okay, that's how you will do the diagrams with the help of integrals. All right, let's go for another example.
Tengo una pregunta.
Yes, una pregunta.
For like the other examples that we've gone over, you know how we would have to find like the area? Like how do you know when we have to find the area and when we don't have to find the area?
Yeah, in this example we need to find one area, because the example that I just did was more to explain how to do the integrals. So if you do the integrals, you just have the equation, so you can find any value of the shear just by plugging the value of the x for a specific point. If you want the shear or the moment at any specific point, you just plug in the x into the equation and then you have it. with the other methods, we need to find the areas. So, well, the areas usually are easy to find it if your load is simple, like for concentrated loads or for uniformly distributed loads, the areas are just triangles or rectangles, very easy. If you have a triangular distributed load like the one we have in the previous example, and in this example we have this, then your areas could be a little more complicated because there will be sectors of parabolas. Let's do this one. This one has that feature, so we can... Reactions. First, reactions. You should be able to find reactions very easily, right? You have to master that already, so let's do it really quickly. Okay, and if we check here the summation of vertical forces, you have 36 going down plus 6 going down, 36 plus 6 going down is 42, and going up you have 9 plus 33, 42. So 42 minus 42, 0. So summation of forces in the y direction checks equals to 0, so you are good. Good, 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 good. All right. Okay. You guys have to be very good at finding reactions. Please, you shouldn't have any doubt about reactions anymore. It should be very easy. Second method, diagrams. So the method I do with the diagrams is that we come here for the shear diagram, go chuku, 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 boom. An arrow telling you to go up 9. So let's do here, let's say this is 5, 10, 15, so 9 will be over here. 9. And then you start the load, the arrows that are telling you to go down, all these arrows are very little at the beginning. So actually it's 0 at the beginning. So you start going horizontal, almost not going down. That means a slope, horizontal slope of 0, and then you start coming down little by little as you move to the right, because the arrows become larger and larger as you move to the right. So you start coming down, and faster and faster as you move to the right, like that, right? And then you come down to a certain point here, and we need to know what is the location of that point. So the way to know how that point is that you start at point A with a shear at point A equals to 9, right? And then at point B, when you arrive to point B from the left, the shear is equal to the 9 that you had at point A minus the area of the whole triangle of the load. And that area is 36. So this is 9 minus 36 is minus 27. So you know that you come down here to minus 27. So if this was like 5, 10, so this is 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 27 will be over here. So let me redo that graph. So this is 27 down here, minus 27. Let me do the drawing. Start with a slope of zero at the beginning, because at the beginning you have very little arrows pointing down. So it means that you almost don't go down. So you start kind of horizontal and then start to move down, 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 down. And every as you move more towards the right, you increase your slope. Okay. So now we have this point here of zero here. Here equals to zero, which is very important because that point is going to determine the point with maximum moment, because if the shear is zero, means that the slope of the moment is zero. You have zero slope. Let me move this right down a little here. So it means that you will have here at the shear equals to zero, you will have something like this in the moment diagram, an horizontal point. That means maximum moment. If it's not maximum, it's minimum, but anyway, it's a very important point. So we need to find this x, let's call it x zero distance. Okay. How we find that x zero distance? The easiest way to find that zero distance is to find, this is another tool to help you build your diagrams, is to find the equation of the shear. Let me show you how to find the equation of the shear in a very easy way. We need to find this x. So we're going to find the equation of the shear in this section here, from point A to point B. In order to do that, you make a cut here at any point at no particular point between A and B. So any point at a distance X, so means any point from A and B. And then if you find that equation and we replace the value of that equation for zero, we can solve for X. So how do you do that? Let me show you. So we have the beam. We make the cut here at a distance x from the support A. The support A has a value of 9. And then we have here the load here, which has an intensity here that we are going to call W of X, because it's the value of the load at a point of coordinate X. The actual load continues here all the way to 12 kilonewtons meter at a distance of 6. So we note that the equation of the load, which is this W of X, is line from x plus b. So the slope is 12 over 6 times x plus b. B is zero because the line goes through zero here where we are starting the measurement of x. This is the origin of coordinates here. Right? So this is the equation of the load. So now, if we make a cut here, as I said, we make a cut here, as soon as you make the cut, you can see the shear right there. See the shear right there. You can see the moment too, but I'm not interested in the moment for now. If I want to find the shear at that moment, what do? I make a summation of forces in the y direction, right? The summation of forces in the y direction has to be equal to zero, because that's in equilibrium. So I'm gonna put positive going down, and then I have that V of X going down positive minus 9 going up plus the load going down, which is the area of this triangle here, the area of that triangle is one half of the base, which is x. This is the base of the triangle, x, times the height of the triangle. The height of the triangle is w of x, which is 12 over 6x plus 0. So this is the summation of forces in the y direction for this little diagram that I made here for a cut of the beam at any at the arbitrary point between A and B at a distance x. So this summation has to be equal to 0. So from here we can get that V of x is equal to, this goes to the other side, 9 minus, this is 12 over 12 is, so this is x squared. 9 minus x squared. And now remember what we were trying to do, we were trying to find this x sub 0. So the x at which the shear is 0. So we say V of x equals question mark equals to 0 equals to 9 minus x squared. Therefore, x equals to the square root of 9 equals to 3. All right. So we found, let's call it x0, right? x0. So now we know that this distance is 3. Question? Very interesting, very interesting. Okay, what else? Now let's continue with the shear diagram that we were doing here. Now we know that the shear diagram goes down, goes through 0 at 3, and keeps down up to minus 27. And now you don't see, you find a load of 33, so you have to go 33 up. So where did you go? We were going here. Let me move this down here. Let's put it here. So I was at minus 27 at D minus. As soon as I move to the right of point V, V plus, I go from minus 27 plus 33 because I found that log minus 27 plus 33 is plus six. So this is going to go up all the way to plus six over here. Right as soon as I pass the load at the support B. That's what I call it B plus. B to the right. This is B before the load, before the reaction, and this is B after the reaction. Then you don't find any load, so you keep going horizontal, and then you find the load of 6 neurons going down, so you go down to 0, and this is plus 6. All right, let's go for the moment diagram now. So we know here that the moment starts at 0. It starts with the slope is given by this value here, 9. So you have a positive slope. You have a 0 slope here at 3 meters from the left. And then you have to go down. What will be the height of the moment here? So we can find it, let's see, we can do an area, right? We can do the moment here at the maximum peak here is equal to the area of this shaded area right there. That would be one way to find it, that area. Let's call it area one. Area one is a section of a parabola. If you have a parabola but you have to be careful because the parabola have to include the vertex of the parabola. As long as the vertex is here, and I mentioned that in another class, if this is H and this is B. Why not? Okay. Then the parabola breaks this rectangle in almost in half, two-thirds of the area here and one-third of the area here. So the area one in this case will be two-thirds of 3 times 9. So this will be 18. So this value here for the maximum moment will be 18. This is provided, remember, that the vertex is included in the corner of the rectangle. If that is not the case, then another way to find the moment at that point will be to make a cut on the beam at that point. Make a cut at 3. Say I'm making a cut. Oh, you don't see it there. Making so going so slow the actualization of the sharing. Oh my goodness, so slow. Okay, so I was making a cut here on the beam. The sharing is going so slow. Do you guys see what I am doing the cut? I'm doing the cut at x equals 3. So let me do that down here somewhere. I don't know where to put it, but it's like the best way to do it. Okay, maybe up here. If I take the beam and I make a cut at 3, and I have here the 9. And I have here the load. And here I have the moment at x equals 3, right? What else I need to put in there? I had here the equation of the load, which was equals to 2x. So this value here of the load is 2x. 2 times 3 equals to 6. So if I do a summation of moments about this section, because you're gonna have a shear here also. If you have to do the summation about the section where you made the cut, so you eliminate that shear, that summation of moments about the point X is equal to 0. So I can do positive like this. Let me open some space, some room here. So you have m at x equals 3 minus 9 times 3 plus the load, the equivalent load that goes in here, that the magnitude of the load will be the area of the triangle, which is 1/2 of 3 times the height, which is 6. Times the lever arm, which is 1/3 of the base, so will be 1, equals to 0. So from here, moment at x equals 3 will be equal to 3 times 9 is 27, minus, this is 3, 6 divided by 2, 3 times 3, 9. So this is equal to 27 minus 9. 27 minus 9 is 18, I hope. So that's the moment at x equals 3 that we already found. Okay, so that's another way to do it. It's kind of like a different way, but in the end it's the same thing, right? And now we need to find the other value, which is that the moment goes down here. We need to find out at what point this goes down here somewhere, this value here, that we can find it as the moment, the same thing that we just did, but using the whole section from A to B. Using the whole section for A to B, we have already all that information. This is 9. This is 36. And this will be the moment at D. And this is 6. So this is 2. So the moment at D, let me see if you can live with this. Will be 9 minus 36. 9 times 6 minus 36 times 2. So it will be equal to 54 minus 72 equals to 54 minus 72 minus 18. Minus 18. So it's plus 18 at the top, minus 18 at the bottom. And now I need to go up by adding this area here. This is 3. This distance is 3 here. So this is 3 times 6, 18. So from minus 18, plus 18 goes back to 0. A little bit messy because of all the explanations that I have to give. But then you have all the elements for your shear diagram. Any questions? So different ways to find all the values that you need to find when you are trying to develop a shear and moment diagram. You need to find all these special points where the shear is 0, where the maximum is moment, at the specific points like the reactions or the supports. All those points are very important. Maximum shear, minimum shear, shear of specific values, all these numbers that I'm gonna put here in green are important. All these numbers are important. Okay, let's do this one last problem here. Okay, so this is another problem. This is actually a frame. It's actually a beam made of two pieces linked at a joint at point C. So you need to find first the reactions. I break the beam already in two on the right in order to find the reactions. So let's break this in two. I remove the support, so I put the actual forces. I have here a reaction at A, and I also have a moment A here, moment A. And I have at C, I have a force that I can call CY. And I have here the action-reaction pair, CY. And that should be it, right? The dimensions, this is 5, this is 6. Okay, so we can start by finding the solving for the reactions at the right, summation of forces, summation of moments at C equals to 0. Positive like this, so I have that 10 times 10 minus RD times 5 equals to 0, so RD equals to 1/5 of 100, so equals to 20. I have 20 here already. I'm gonna put it right here because this is what I needed. 20, let's put it here just in case, 20. And now I do summation of moments about point D equals to 0, positive any way we want. What do I have? I have 10 times 5 minus cy times 5 equals to 0. So I have cy equals to 50 divided by 5 equals to 10. So this is equal to 10. So let me put it right here also, 10. And then I can find, using this diagram, summation of moments about point A equals to 0, positive like this, in order to find the moment at the support at A. So I have MA minus 10 times 14 plus 40. This is where many people fail in the exam. Many people didn't include this moment on the summation of moments. Remember, there was an example similar to this one with a concentrated moment at some point. And in the summation of moments, you guys didn't include the moment. This is crazy. It's like that you have a party, you're going to get a lot of people and say, it's a party for red-headed people. And you don't send the invitation to people with red hair, just to the rest of the people, but not the people with red hair or whatever. It's a summation of moments. So the first thing that has to go into that summation is the moments. Right? I don't know why, but well, probably because we are so used to summation of moments, to making the summation of all the forces times the distance and the other force times the distance. And then when you see this moment, you kind of like don't recognize it that quickly, because we are so used to moment being force times distance. But when you find a concentrated moment, it's the first one that has to go into your summation of moments. Don't forget it. Don't ever forget it. Summation of moments. The moments are the first one that have to go into a party for moments. Okay, where were we? Moment A equals to 140 minus 40 equals to 100. Then this is 100 here. And I'm gonna put it here also. So we have a moment clockwise. Oh, let's put it in red. 100. And then summation of moments in the point C equals to 0, positive like this. Then RA times, this distance is 8. This is not 5, this is 8. 8 meters, 14. Again, another summation of moments. You have to include the 40 plus 40, and you have to include the 100 plus 100 equals to 0. So you have RA equals to 1 over 14 times minus 140. So you got minus 10. So I got it wrong. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. So this direction is actually going down 10. The reaction at this support is 10 going down. Okay, so we have the reactions. We are ready for our diagrams. Let's get this out of the way. So we go for our shear diagram. This is gonna be easy. When you don't have distributed load, everything is very easy. So you go again, you chugu, 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 boom, load going down 10. Let's say this is 5, this is 10. No, too big, too big. Let's say this is 5, 10, minus 10. Then you keep going horizontal. There is no forces, no forces, no forces, no forces, no forces, no forces, no forces. Boom, a force of 20. So you go up 20, minus 10, plus 20. Then you go to plus 10. And then no forces, no forces, no forces. Boom, 10 going down, 10 going down, 0. this your shear diagram. No problem with your shear diagram. This is a little ugly, so this is a little more beautiful. Now, moment. Remember what we said about when you find a concentrated moment, your diagram has to go up and down in a sharp vertical motion. So when you have moment in the clockwise direction, you move up, counterclockwise move down. So this one, the 100 moment here is clockwise. So you move up 100. Let's say this is 100. And then you start going down by these areas here. So let's say you want to go down up to some point here where you meet the 40 moment. So let's see what is this area. And you have to go from 100 minus that area, which is 10 times 8. So will be 100 minus 80. So you will get a 20. So you go down up to 20. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So you get up to here. So that will be your point of arrival here, 20. At this point, you find your concentrated moment of 40 in the clockwise direction, so you have to go up 20 plus 40, 60. So this is 60. And then you keep going down according to this area. This area is 6 times 10. So it's 60, so 60 minus 60 goes to 0, and then keeps going. So you are 0, and then this other area is, so this area is 60, and this area is 5 times 10, this is 50. So this goes down to minus 50. And then you find this area, which is 10 times, so this is 50 also, so you go up 50 up to 0. And that's it. A very nice thing to point here, look, this moment is 0 here. Moment equal to 0. Isn't that nice? Why the moment is 0 there? Because there is a hinge there. There is a pin connection at that point. So there is no way the pin can hold any moment there. That's why the moment diagram goes through 0 in that point. All right. And that will be the end of that diagram. Remember, for a diagram like this, it's important to have all these values, this value here. Maybe pointing somehow point that the zero occurs at the joint C. All right. Well, that would be safe. We didn't say bye-bye.